much the only team between North America and Europe that run this composition so frequently and at such a high level. There have definitely been certain compositions that teams have sort of made their main comp. We don't really see that a lot. We often see diversity and changing comps frequently, but this Elemental Shaman Boomkin, on paper, I would say, should be losing to the Rogue Mage Druid. There's so much crowd control for the Mistweaver, so much so that Lunia has actually decided to not run the Honor Talent Way of the Crane, so he's not going to be running in and punching any faces, as that would expose his positioning. So Lunia, we anticipate to be focusing on some defensive play and avoiding combat, and I'm wondering how Change My Mind are going to navigate around that decision. A very early blind play gets Looney's Glider's Medallion out of the way. Icy Veins popped as well, so Fried Kitty looking to maybe bait an Astral Shift, but has to actually evacuate. Morrow's damage too high. Fried Kitty gets out of there, but Acro now left behind. Morrow swings over, tosses out a Star Surge. Acro now trying to retreat back to the pillar. And Poike, though, out in midfield, has to reposition. His team is healthy. They're going to recover. And now we need to take stock of the cooldowns.
Yeah, I mean, when we looked at all the series that have played out today, it's been Rogue, Mage, Druid that has beaten basically everything. So I feel like for a team like Wildcard Gaming, they have to figure out a composition they can beat Rogue, Mage, Druid with consistently. Maybe this is the answer. They found the Moonkin, the Elemental Shaman, and the Mistweaver Monks. Traditionally, Mistweaver Monks aren't the greatest into Rogue, Mage in a matchup like this, just as you are so susceptible to different crowd controls. But Looney's going to be moving in, getting aggressive with the double leg sweep. Now it's up to Morrow and Z-Bot to find the burst damage that they really need. But Rogue Mage Druid seems to be the story of the European scene right now.
And one thing, though, is Minpoike's Paladin at the Spring Finals, and more importantly, the Repentance talent that Paladins can bring, really allowed his team victory. Of course, having a Mage, you don't really need that diminishing return. Polymorph is the same crowd control effectively, but so far, I would say the chains have been effective from Change My Mind, now working through the Life Cocoon, shredding that like butter. Hex on a Fried Kitty. Dispelled by Minpoike. Vendetta still available, though Z-Pi has Astral Shift ready and waiting to be lined up with that. Ring of Peace protects Z-Pi during this kidney shot. Fried Kitty takes some burst from Morrow. Counterspells Morrow on his Cyclone. It's very important that Morrow gets Counterspell out of the way during a non-kill attempt so that he can freely Cyclone and save Z-Pi when they are going for a kill. So that is some anticipated play by Morrow to get the Counterspell out of the way. It also just makes it easier for Looney to heal if that isn't available. They disarm Acro during his Vendetta, so he's unable to attack. They then chain that into a Lightning Lasso, further preventing his assault. And now if they absolutely need to, they can Astral Shift. A bit surprising to not see it traded one for one in that assault, but maybe not necessary as Z-Pi got into Ghost Wolf and was able to heal through the damage.
Yep. Z-Pi is going to be kiting away in Ghost Wolf right now. Acro chasing him across the map. What is he going to be able to get done? To see Fried Kitty following up some damage as well. Morrow with a nice bash, getting good crowd control in the matchup. And Poike in midfield looking for CC. Lightning Lasso on Fried Kitty. Do they have the burst to potentially force out that first ice block? And Poike Trinkets trades out the Iron Bar to keep Fried Kitty alive. Now it's Z-Pi that's in trouble, but Life Cocoon completely denies his attempt. Not actually sure. They might have the damage to just shred through, but the damage falls off. Looney with a very heads-up play there. Knew he was going to get Polymorph, throws out the Life Cocoon, and keeps Z-Pi alive.
I wonder if it's almost a bad thing that they can play with Fried Kitty now. And if they couldn't play with him, then they would be forced to run their Shadow Priest Rogue Paladin, because they were so good on it, and it was effective against Wildcard Gaming. But now that they have Fried Kitty available to play, they're going to be locking him in here for game number one. This attempt looks very solid, although Minpoike is shut down on his Cyclone by Morrow, and because of that shutdown, now he can easily heal Z-Pi back to full health. Morrow trying to lob out some burst in that Bash Lightning Lasso combo, but Fried Kitty uses Glider's Medallion to escape its stun lock and blink back to the pillar out of line of sight. Earthquake positioned down onto the entire team of Change My Mind. They are pinned at the pillar for now by Z-Pi and Morrow. If we look at mana, there's a slight lead for Change My Mind, but it's not really that significant just yet, as it is likely that we are going into dampening between these two teams. Z-Pi has preempted basically every attack in Ghost Wolf, and I don't think that Fried Kitty is... I've got two mages on the desk, so you can correct me if I'm wrong here, but you don't typically run the Kleptomania and the Temporal Shield, so it's unlikely that he is running Kleptomania. You don't normally run Kleptomania facing a Mistweaver Monk, but to remove the Ghost Wolf is almost mandatory, so perhaps he's saving his mana for spell steals during cooldowns so that they can remove the Ghost Wolf and not spending his mana on those outside of it. How do you feel about the spell steal usage overall from Fried Kitty?
I don't know if he actually is. Is he playing Kleptomania? It's not that uncommon that a mage will play both Temporal Shield and Kleptomania in a matchup like this. Like you said, if he can remove the Ghost Wolf as well as get off an Enveloping Mist and a Renewing Mist during a kill attempt, it is pretty massive for the team, but we'll have to see exactly how that plays out. Fried Kitty still looking to build up some damage over on Azeepi. Azeepi is still just kiting across the map. He wants to constantly be dragging Fried Kitty out of position, Acro out of position so they can get some damage rolling, but it looks like it's going to be Azeepi that's in some trouble, but a beautiful Ring of Peace denies the smoke bomb attempt from Acro. Azeepi does manage to hold on just a little bit longer, but the damage coming in from Fried Kitty and Acro is actually surprising. Looney forced to trade out that life cocoon to keep him alive. Azeepi still running away. And Sid, I can't help but feel like Wildcard Gaming, they have not found their footing in this matchup. It doesn't look like they have much pressure. There's not many attempts for a kill. Maybe right now on Acro with the Lightning Lasso, they could be able to take him down. Nice stun lock combo coming in from Azeepi, but they don't have the damage to really follow up. Minpoike is able to keep him alive with that Iron Bark.
I will say Acro using Faint before the stun is the only reason he's alive right now. He 100% died in that Lightning Lasso, so Acro's anticipated play there keeps his team alive in game number one, and they do not lose the swing match advantage. They definitely had a stronger footing so far in game number one as we move towards dampening, although an Elemental Shaman you cannot count out. At any moment, Nurse Shock could just kill you. You pair that up with a Balanced Druid with some Star Surges, and then you're almost certainly dead. So even though Wildcard Gaming are playing from behind for basically this entire game, at any moment, if they interrupt Minpoike, even crowd control him for a second, they could just blast somebody out of the match. As in this situation,
whoa!
Acro is just dead.
Deleted.
Wildcard Gaming being behind the entire time, kill him exactly after.
Surviving as long as he possibly can, using his Novas, using the Ice Nova, to sort of limit the mobility that Blizzo has available. And if he can do a really good job of doing that, if Minpoike and Acro can back him up, they can definitely find victory in this matchup. But Wildcard Gaming with the Windwalker Death Knight, this is a really, really powerful setup.
Azeepi early on just softening up Fried Kitty, removing that ice barrier absorption effect, trying to put some early pressure to pull Minpoike out of stealth, who has now left stealth. Blizzo is likely the target for most of this fight, with some pretty big damage early on, but Acro Lol currently unable to attack with that grapple weapon, removing his weapon. Gripping a double stun swap to Minpoike. Bit of an all-in attempt here from Wildcard Gaming in game number two, trying to take down Minpoike, but easily denied with the usage of Bark Skin. However, the next time that he is gripped in, if he is not in bear form, Touch of Death is available for Blizzo. So let's see if Blizzo can get that set up with Azeepi in roughly probably 40 seconds from now with the leg sweep. They're actually going for the Touch of Death on a different target. Fried Kitty already had Temporal, so they're trying to race a game. They're actually just killing through it. They're going to get the first ice block.
Wow.
And that's exactly what they needed to get with Touch of Death. Another attempt like that, then two ice blocks will be burned, and then another attempt like that again, and Change My Mind will be on match point.
Yeah, that was Iron Bark, Temporal Shield, and Ice Block traded out there by Change My Mind. Really overwhelming damage. Dark Simulacrum is going to be used by Azeepi, so Minpoike and Fried Kitty have to make sure they're not giving him additional crowd control. He can steal those abilities from Fried Kitty and Minpoike with that ability. Looney getting swapped too, taking a little bit of damage as he leaps away. Ray of Frost being channeled out there by Fried Kitty. Looney should be able to survive off the back of that Gladiator Safeguard. Good positioning. Now Blizzo getting swapped to. Acro looking to reverse the pressure, keeping up his consistent damage on Blizzo. Azeepi grips Acro. They're actually going for a swap on Acro. He's got no trinket. They might be able to take him down. Do they have another stun? Evasion should be enough to keep him alive. Looney actually getting caught in Hibernate. Nicely done by Minpoike. We said he's been on the up and up. He's on fire, and he's really showcasing it in this matchup.
Although they dropped the chain with the Cyclone, now Looney bashes in response, try and give his team an opening. Minpoike has to worry about both players, Fried Kitty and Acro, as they got Acro's evasion in that last attack. So Minpoike is likely to spend more mana because he has to worry about two targets, whereas Looney really, I think, only has to worry about himself in this position. Blizzo with the Touch of Karma available to survive. Burst on Fried Kitty. If they can get an ice block before Touch of Death, that's basically game over for Change My Mind. They grip Fried Kitty in.
Ooh.
They've still got pressure. Blizzo, though, goes after Acro instead. Maybe they just want to cut this game short and just find a kill on the Rogue. Maybe bait Minpoike into using Iron Bark. Paralysis on the Tranquility, well-timed there. Denying the Area of Effect heal to heal two members of the team. So good interrupt by Blizzo. Touch of Death available in 5 more seconds for Blizzo. And if he goes after Acro, no trinkets for Leg Sweep, and they crowd control Minpoike, at the same moment, then Acro will just effectively be erased from the game. So there's a 20-second window here where Wildcard Gaming could just get a kill and end the game, although they need to survive to it. Blizzo Transcendence is away. That window is slowly closing. I mean, it's 10 seconds away. They get Npoike Clone. They need the leg sweep or a bash. They bash Acro, but they're not going after Acro, instead going after Fried Kitty. Iron Bark used onto him, maybe now going back onto Acro, but he'll have Trinket for the leg sweep. I can't help but feel that maybe there was a kill opportunity lost there for Wildcard Gaming if they'd been on a different target, that being Acro.
Yeah, Blizzo falling a little bit behind. Looney does manage to play catch up with the Innervate, as well as the Iron Bark. Minpoike actually having to run away for a drink in this specific situation. Touch of Death once again getting committed here. Lot of potential damage on Fried Kitty. He's trying to survive with the Temporal Shield, but the burst is just so high. Doesn't want to throw away the game. He has to hold on just a little bit longer. Temporal Shield tops him off from 10%. Really well done. Good patience there. Definitely a risky play, but ends up saving him that precious ice block cooldown. Now looking to get aggressive with the Icy Veins. Turning around the pressure over on Alunius. They look for a one-shot kill. Acro gets disarmed. Bash followed up the CC. Byman Poike onto Looney. Looney with a beautiful Shadow Meld now into a Cyclone. Now there's an opportunity if Acro and Fried Kitty can line up some damage. Looney could easily fall.
I mean, they can definitely get a Glider's Medallion from Looney, and if they can do that, then they can blind him later, get a kill on the Windwalker. They're going after Blizzo. Looney repositions. Blizzo should be all right, but I guess Looney wants to be patient with his Iron Bark just in case he gets swapped back to later on. So he's powering through with regrowths, which do cost a lot of mana, but he's already so far ahead, and it looks like he's even going to be trying to sit down for a drink. If he drinks back to full, most certainly moving into dampening, their team has the edge and the lead and looking likely to put Change My Mind on match point. And I can't help but feel that they are maybe disappointed if they could so easily deal with Change My Mind at their full power roster. But at the same time, maybe Change My Mind are just second guessing themselves when they're not forced to play with Valet. And maybe that's actually an advantage to Wildcard Gaming. Fried Kitty at half health, and Poike uses Iron Bark. That should be enough. I say should be enough. Very, a lot of emphasis on the should. Fried Kitty survives. Dampening has entered the fray. That will reduce healing over time, which then does open Z-Pi up as a target. Z-Pi is running a Gnome Death Knight, so to be more aggressive, but loses out on the Dark Iron Dwarf's Fireblood Racial to remove Glider Maledix trinkets. So if Change My Mind can maintain into the 30-40% dampening mark, T-Pi certainly can be a target.
Yep, Fried Kitty still getting bursted down. Temporal Shield once again trying to save the day. Fried Kitty blinks in. They're trying to get the damage rolling onto Looney, but he's going to be A-OK completely fine. Blizzo has been doing a really good job backing up Looney in this situation. He is playing the Grapple Weapon Honor talent, so he can basically disarm Acro, uses Detox, and that's going to be a very safe Looney in that situation. Fried Kitty blinking in, gets the Polymorph onto Z, but actually breaks. Acro pokes it, unfortunately. Blizzo now still trying to get some damage rolling, but all six members' health have basically been completely reset in the situation. See, Fried Kitty has the Cold Snap available once again. That means he's going to have both of his Ice Blocks available in this specific situation as we do move towards 10% dampening.
So instead, they look to switch targets and go after Minpoike, but Acro Law was there to save the day, and now Blizzo is under pressure. Will he be able to stay alive? Looks like they just want to all in. Z-Pi is marching forward. Minpoike on the run. Manages to escape for now. Blizzo trades out Touch of Karma. So Blizzo is definitely the target for now. Although deeper into dampening, certainly Z-Pi can become one. Z-Pi has Anti-Magic Zone. That's going to be the defensive cooldown that Wildcard Gaming need to utilize on the next attack, which could be engaged at any moment, although being stalled out for now. Fried Kitty has Temporal Shield rolling on the Fists of Fury, absorbing all of its damage and healing himself back up to full. It was well-timed, but now stunned without its defense. Blizzo still with nothing either. If they can lock him down in a stun and crowd control Looney at the same moment, maybe they're waiting for Looney to try and cast with a Blink counter spell, although you don't normally use the Shimmers offensively. Fried Kitty trying to blink away from the fight, grip back in, blinks again, but they will ultimately reconnect. Now Ursul's Vortex is down, and Fried Kitty is unable to move. Minpoike is going to have to heal through all of this damage, and he doesn't have a lot of mana to do it.
Big burst damage on Fried Kitty. Are they going to get the ice block? No, Minpoike with a huge heal with that Iron Bark. Fried Kitty was a bit of a sitting duck right there. Unfortunately, didn't have any of his shimmers available. Now looking to get aggressive with the Icy Veins. Manages to find the Polymorph. Blizzard with a preemptive Transcendence. Nowhere to be found. And Fried Kitty basically essentially wasted that Icy Veins, didn't get any damage rolling, but Acro in the meantime is basically soloing Blizzo. Acro may have been playing this way too aggressively, he's in a lot of trouble. He has to trade out potentially the Faint, the Cloak of Shadows, and the Evasion, but Blizzo in the meantime falls through Ironbark. That was big damage coming from Change My Mind. I really thought he was going to survive, and I think he almost had the touch
map in Legion, but you actually see the Nether Drakes flying above.
Where have you been?
I didn't notice those there.
How long have you been shoutcasting this?
I've never seen a Nether Drake above this arena.
All right. Well, I guess it's the first time for everything,
well,
truly.
Lun.
Yeah. Z5's going to get sapped up. Blizzo in midfield. He was the target for Change My Mind in the last game. So definitely going to have to do a good job playing solid defense in this matchup. Fraud Kitty, like I said, if he's going to play up top on this bridge, it really limits the space he has to sort of kite around with Minpoike. So if he is in trouble, I expect him to be running away at some point using sort of the outskirts of the map. But for now, he's playing very aggressive, already forcing out the Touch of Karma from Blizzo. He's going to trade that out no problem onto Acro, trying to get some damage rolling. But you can get tricked as a Windwalker Death Knight to playing a little bit too defensive. We definitely don't want to see that from Blizzo. And on that Windwalker Monk, he needs to be playing very aggressive onto Fried Kitty, limiting his damage, keeping up the burst as much as possible. If he plays overly defensive, it basically allows Change My Mind these sort of windows of opportunity where they can get super aggressive on the Looney as well. Sort of really keep Wildcard Gaming guessing.
So Looney got Shadow Melt usage there on two Gladiator Maledict trinkets. 2 out of 3 for one Shadow Melt. That's a high value trade for Looney. Little misfire by Change My Mind as they committed all of their cooldowns to All In and they didn't even scratch. Perfect trade from Wildcard Gaming, as would be expected. Their ironclad defense is the most notable thing I would say for Wildcard Gaming as a roster. Perfect shot calling there on the side of Looney. And Poike is already trying to maybe try and drink early on, but the ghoul from Zipai is sent his way to keep him in combat and will be chasing him down. Now, this map is much worse for Fried Kitty's mobility, but and also a lot better for Blizzo's mobility. So this, I do like this map selection from Wildcard Gaming. We don't see Blade's Edge Arena picked that much, but in this exact situation, it was the perfect pick.
Yeah, I mean, definitely is looking good for them so far. Fried Kitty has essentially nowhere he can run. Temporal Shield bounces his health back up. And in this series so far, Fried Kitty has been doing a phenomenal job making sure he gets well-timed Temporals, sort of negate a lot of the burst damage the Windwalker Monk has available. In the meantime, Looney caught into the bash. Good burst damage coming in from Fried Kitty and Acro. Polymorph secured by Zipa. And this is what I was talking about with the Dark Simulacrum. Zipai has the potential to basically steal spells from Fried Kitty and Minpoike. And the main spells he wants to take is the crowd control, the polymorph, the cyclone. When he can get that, that's when they can get a lot of this burst damage rolling and potentially force out an ice block on Fried Kitty.
Yeah, that's definitely a window of opportunity for Wildcard Gaming. They need to win this if they want to keep or have even an opportunity to get the swing match advantage for a game number 5. Everything could come down to just game number 1, though. Looney in a blind. Acro gets his grapple weaponed and denied on the sap. Well done by Blizzo, breaking the crowd control chain for his healer. Now Minpoike in a bit of trouble as Blizzo goes on a solo mission trying to kill Minpoike. Big hits. Zipai tries to switch as well, but Acro saves him. Looney then gets stunned up. Minpoike tag teaming here onto Looney. Ray of Frost, fake cast by Fried Kitty, trying to fake some of the interrupts that he can free cast later on. They decide to commit the anti-magic zone, this purple bubble of protection that Looney will stay inside whenever Acro activates Vendetta or Fried Kitty activates Icy Vein. So that's still a fair one-for-one exchange. Mana is even at this point. That's not really too good, I believe, for Minpoike's team, as the pressure from Wildcard Gaming is consistent, whereas Change My Mind is all about burst. Fried Kitty under huge fire. Minpoike desperately trying to stabilize with only Ironbark. Innervate well timed, but now stunned and gripped into the fight. So another swap. I do like Wildcard Gaming ping-ponging between targets to try and develop a mana lead.
Yeah, and I mean, they have that mana lead right now. Minpoike is going to have to play very efficient from this point moving forward if he wants to go toe-to-toe with the mana of Looney. But Zipai and Blizzo, they are not making that easy. Like you said, they're sort of bouncing around. They hit Fried Kitty, get out some major heals, then swap to Minpoike, force him to heal himself up. And I think it's a good strategy. Right now, Looney caught into a kitty shot once again. What are they going to be able to do? Grapple weapon. And like, I like this talent choice from Blizzo. Instead of playing the Fortifying Brew, which is more standard, he's playing the grapple weapon to deny these swaps. He probably realizes Rogue Mage Druid, they want to go after the healer as often as possible, so being able to grapple weapon Acro during those boast moments and use the detox to dispel his poisons really allows Looney to survive in those situations quite easily. So really well done heads up play there by Wildcard Gaming. And Poike currently sitting in cat form. Is he going to be able to recover some of his mana? We will have to see shortly.
He got quite a bit in that exchange, which gives Change My Mind an opportunity to maybe just advance to match point against Wildcard Gaming. Although Blizzo has a lot of defense, so they will have to work through that. I mean, Poike swap two again. Beautiful swaps from Wildcard Gaming. Perhaps the end of the match as Fried Kitty desperately tries to back Poike up. Acro is forced to use blind defensively, which means that Looney will now actually get sapped, so maybe have to trinket. I'm surprised they didn't actually just trinket so it's on cooldown with blind. Blizzo stunned up. Ray of Frost fully channeled.
Uh-oh.
A bit of a disrespectful trade here. And that's going to cost them Touch of Karma and Iron Bark at the same time, but they could just easily swing it around and finish Poike as he ducks off the side of the bridge. Both melee get Frost Nova. Zipai's dispelled out. Blizzo looks to reconnect. Looney on the run. Blizzo poly. No one's able to connect. They make a swap to Looney. Poike even jumping into the fight to try and add a bit of extra damage to finish him off, but it is not enough. Anti-magic zone once again perfectly exchanged for the Vendetta of Acro. Looney in bear form and should easily be recovering. Acro gets stunned up. Blizzo firing away with those Fists of Fury. Now Acro stable. Slight mana lead for Change My Mind. Slight cooldown lead for Change My Mind as well. And this is very surprising given that the map should be advantageous to Wildcard Gaming.
Acro trading out of Vanish, looking to deny the drink attempt there by Looney. Did a good job. Gets the Garrote Silence. He was looking for a sap, but Looney realized exactly what was happening. Now that Looney sort of softened up from that Garrote and Rupture, he gets caught into a kidney shot. Iron Bark is going to be preemptively used on himself to stay alive. He didn't have to trade out his trinket. He has Barkskin rotating back up for this next kill attempt. Now a beautiful double leg sweep coming in from Blizzo. Good counter pressure. And Poike could be in a little bit of trouble as he gets gripped back. It's actually Ursula's Vortex, though. Poike could be in some trouble. He jumps off the bridge in order to survive. Fried Kitty's been doing a great job making sure to keep control on Blizzo and Zipai. And now an interrupt on Looney. Blizzo could easily fall and does. Changed My Mind puts another point on the board, and now leading in the series. Ursula wants to avoid being sent down to that lower bracket. So far, it's been a race between Wildcard Gaming and Method Black. Method Black, they've kept their upper bracket position. Wildcard Gaming, they're looking to do the same, but Changed My Mind might be able to deny them here. And Wildcard Gaming getting sent to the lower bracket in basically a sea of rogue mages is definitely not the spot you want to be. They have to try to claim victory here in game number four.
Yeah, hopefully Changed My Mind don't play chicken here as they're just hanging out next to all the little chickens on hook point. Early exchange between Fried Kitty and Maro as Acro sneaks across the map, as rogues are known to do. Not opening just yet. He probably wants to set up a cheap shot on Looney for a polymorph or Ring of Frost, so he's just holding out. Or maybe just open on Zipai around the corner. Fried Kitty actually blinking next to Zipai. Maybe a smoke bomb early on. Shadow Step on the Thunderstorm. Acro reconnects. They've removed the Ghost Wolf, so this is the most important thing to get off of the Shaman player when you are trying to kill them. If they're in Ghost Wolf, they will heal themselves up quite easily. But regardless, they don't even get an Iron Bark on that attempt. The Pharaoh is not the Icy Veins or Vendetta. So moving forward, they still have those cooldowns in their back pocket to pop at any moment. I'm going to keep my eyes on Poike's mana because that is the main objective that Wildcard Gaming are playing for, is to run that blue bar below Poike's orange health bar down all the way to zero so it's no longer there and he can no longer heal. This is the main priority for Wildcard Gaming.
Yep. Get the blue bar down, especially in the earlier stages of the game. Acro now caught into a bash, taking a little bit of burst damage here once again. We've seen him being blown out of the water before by Zipai and by Maro, so he has to be very scared. Gladiator Safeguard gets taken out of the way. He no longer has that safety net for the next minute or two. And it looks like Change My Mind, they're going to be stable. They're going to be fine. They really just want to punish Acro when he gets aggressive in this matchup. Fried Kitty's playing really defensive. Then Poike and Fried Kitty, normally you see the mage, the Restoration Druid push in, try to get crowd control, but they're basically just throwing Acro in, allowing him to be abused by Zipai and Maro in this particular matchup. And I think it's a scary dance for Change My Mind in this matchup, because at any moment, Acro could easily get just blown out of the water by a big Urshot crit.
Yeah, but if he doesn't, then Change My Mind take match point and advance in the upper bracket to face against Method Black. Solar Beam landed there onto the entire team, disrupting the crowd control of Change My Mind. And Poike's mana is more than solid at this point. If he can maintain without even drinking, that's definitely a statement, considering that is the main thing that Wildcard Gaming are playing for, and they're not even building that advantage for themselves just yet. Fried Kitty cycloned up. Mara repositions but gets stunned. Acro reconnects. Fried Kitty would have liked to continue the crowd control chain but was unable to due to Mara's cyclone. Looney repositions in the frozen orb, so if potentially a polymorph is casted, it will break, but then reconvenes away, realizing that Fried Kitty is not going to be making that error and doesn't want to feed any potential extra damage. Fried Kitty and Minpoike, they're playing defensive, but they've left Acro pushed pretty far forward. Maro's in position to cyclone Minpoike if he tries to cross midfield. I'm curious if Maro can intercept Minpoike. Minpoike doesn't need to so long as Acro doesn't line of sight. Zipai should be looking to reposition. They just go for the stun anyway onto Acro. They actually double stun, so this prevents Lightning Lasso from being interrupted. They get some guaranteed damage on Fried Kitty, and it's all about damage if they want to run Minpoike out of mana, so I do like that adaptation, using the stuns onto two players at the same time and prevent their interrupts on Lightning Lasso. Minpoike sits down for a drink. Maro doesn't know where it is, so Minpoike is going to get full mana. Again, not developing that lead, which is one of the main win conditions. The other win condition would be just destroying someone in the Lightning Lasso with a couple of Star Surges, which could happen here. Acro saw it coming and activated Faint right before it, so that reduced a lot of damage, and Minpoike also allocated his Iron Bark to prevent a kill there, which is why we'd see Acro's health not even move. So there's some situations there where if Acro didn't see that coming, if Minpoike under-responded, Acro is removed from the game almost immediately. But because they anticipate the attack, they activate their defense within a millisecond response, nothing happens. But that was a very important decision on Acro Lol's part to be able to stay alive and nullify that attack from Wildcard Gaming.
Yeah, I mean, Acro's been doing a good job sort of reading the situation so far in this matchup, you know, preemptively using the feints, like you kind of said, to avoid those big one-shot attempts from Maro and Zipai. If you look at mana, right now, Minpoike is using his Innervate at around 90% mana, Looney hovering around the same, so it's basically a tied ball game at this point. I mean, change my mind, they are in favor right now, of course, being up 2-1 in this series. Wildcard Gaming, they have to get a win in this matchup if they want to avoid that treacherous lower bracket. Now, Looney actually trading out his trinket, so that's no longer going to be available. Fried Kitty and Minpoike, they can push in and get one good crowd control. They could even potentially go after Looney as a target. They might be able to just move in if Minpoike can build up some damage for that Feral Affinity. They could just try to blow Looney out of the water with a big attempt here, but with no Vendetta, no Icy Veins available, it's going to be a really difficult task to actually pull off.
That is definitely going to be a difficult task to pull off. In the meantime, Minpoike is crowd controlled and Acro is the target. This is usually where it would be very scary, but Acro already saw it coming and repositioned at the pillar, line of sighting the attacks, and is completely stable. So Acro's awareness in this match has been on point, and as long as it remains on point, they remove that win condition of basically just typing slash delete Acro lulls. They remove that win condition.
Is that a command?
And they maintain, yes it is now, and maintain their mana, then they are, I would say, almost guaranteed to win against Wildcard Gaming here on match point. So everything rests on Acro lulls ability to predict attacks and Poike's ability to maintain mana, and both of those have looked solid, and Daphne's already at 6%.
Yeah, Acro's really been doing an outstanding job in this matchup so far, making sure he's staying alive. Really excellently done, honestly. Acro now caught into a bash. Minpoike denies with the Iron Bark, and that will, you know, keep Acro alive. You know, Looney, realizing the situation, throws a Cyclone over onto Acro to deny, and now at 8% dampening. I mean, so far it's been a bit of a stalemate, but dampening inevitably will end this game, so one of these teams is going to have to look to get a little bit more aggressive.
It's a stalemate that I think is a guaranteed victory for Change My Mind, unless they make a mistake at this point. They've got basically full mana at 10% dampening. Zipai eventually just can't be healed anymore through the Assassination Rogue pressure. Looney is already struggling, even at only 10% dampening, is reluctant to trade Iron Bark in this position. There's the counter engagement. Acro did not have Faint for this, so it's going to be quite scary. Double Star Surge or Shock. Could be a Cloak of Shadows. He ducks around the corner. Minpoike's there. The crowd control is faded, and they stabilize without having to trade any major cooldowns. Now Acro Lol's on the attack, gunning down Zipai. They need to get rid of the Ghost Wolf. I think I can see Ghost Wolf there in the Frozen Aura. A bit difficult. Zipai out of Ghost Wolf now, taking a huge hit. Iron Bark, is it going to be enough? We're at 13% dampening. Big Comet Storm. Zipai holds out. Now in Ghost Wolf. Actually canceling it a bit early. Astral Shift for Vendetta. Fair trade. Hex Fried Kitty. Bash Acro. Fried Kitty actually used the Glider's Medallion on Hex to try and kill. Aggressive decision from Fried Kitty that could be punished later on with maybe a Lightning Lasso, but momentum is swinging in favor of Change My Mind more and more.
Yeah, Shadow Step cheap shot over on the Looney Teal. Zipai still in a lot of trouble into the Growth Silence. Maro now into a Cyclone. Really good control coming in from Change My Mind. That was a good attempt over on the Zipai, but he gets topped off. Wildcard gaining completely stabilizes. Now we're basically waiting for the incarnation of Morrow for them to get really aggressive in this matchup. 23 seconds, that's going to be a lot of firepower Morrow has available to try to take down Acro, maybe even Fried Kitty, but they haven't been doing any work on Fried Kitty this matchup. He has both of his ice blocks, he has his cold snap, and Poike has been able to easily keep him alive. I'm just not sure they're going to be able to take down Acro, especially with how well he's been playing defensively with that feint.
I don't think they're going to take him down. We're now at 20% Dapidim, and Poike's still mana, full mana. Acro still has his whole defensive lineup. There's no win condition right now for Wildcard Gaming, and the consistent pressure of the Assassination Rogue will overwhelm them slowly but surely. So if you're Change My Mind, you're all smiles right now, and you're likely going in the upper bracket against Method Black. I don't even think that Method Black could have anticipated this. And then if you're in the lower bracket, you're left pretty scared with Wildcard Gaming already down there so early on. Europe is just having the table flipped with Change My Mind powering up for the summer season. Of course, we don't want to count them out just yet, but it's looking like at this point that it's pretty much in the bag. Acrolol jumping into the fight. Mooney was drinking. He's at least back to full mana. Both druids drinking, which is surprising on hook point that you see both druids able to just freely drink at 24% dampening. Maybe some mistakes made here. This is the stun lock on Acro. This is normally a scary moment. Minpoike realizes this is relying on his iron bark, which now is more than enough for him to survive. And Acro holds onto Cloak of Shadows, which is his get out of jail free card, basically, as it makes him immune to all magic damage. Wildcard Gaming only do magic damage. So it's a pretty good cooldown to have, and he wants to use that as the last line of defense so that he can push forward and end the game with a safety net. Two members in crowd control, Z-Pi all alone.
Uh-oh.
Change My Mind looking to send him down to the lower bracket as Z-Pi's on the run, trying to hightail it out to safety, but Glaier's Maledict is going to absorb a lot of healing. Dark Iron Dwarf, Fireblood activated. Z-Pi's still low on health, but the crowd control's ended. They smoke bomb to stall the Iron Bark. They stun Looney from stealth to buy them even just an extra second. Looney has to trinket a diminishing return Cyclone. He's
That's
open to
it.
Blind in
no
the future,
way.
But I don't even think they need the blind. The
no
pressure
way.
Is so high. Maybe it's not enough, but even if they don't kill Z-Pi, they cycle him at low health.
Minpoike, oh!
Minpoike is playing out of his mind this entire tournament.
Good night.
Out of his mind. 3-1, advancing to face Method Black tomorrow.
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered in the middle of history the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.